Hi, I'm Cody Smith, Tech Support Manager for Cloyes Gear and Products, and this is version 2 of our Ecotec time and chain replacement video. We received great feedback on our first video, but we wanted to expand on the original, address some commonly asked questions, and touch on later model VVT equipped engines. Cloyes offers a full product line of components and kits for the Ecotec engine. Here's a look at the timing components we will be installing in this video. Primary time and chain set, part number 9-4201S, comes with the chain, tensioner, guides, sprockets, the cam sprocket bolts, and a new oiling nozzle. And the 9-4202S balance shaft kit will include the balance shaft chain, tensioner, guides, and sprockets. We also offer a primary time and chain kit for variable valve timing applications that comes without cam sprockets, part number 9-4201SA, and sprocketless kits for both primary and balance shaft systems, 9-4201SX and 9-4202SX respectively. Please visit the buyer's guide on our website for application lookup. Timing system replacement can be done with the engine in the vehicle. To get started, remove the valve cover and the front engine cover to access the timing and balance shaft components. With the covers off, but before removing any components, rotate the engine to number one top dead center on the exhaust stroke. This is the position the engine needs to be in for time and chain installation. To do this, there are only two things you need to look at: the position of the crankshaft key and the timing marks on the cam sprockets. When the crankshaft key is at 12 o'clock, number one is at top dead center. However, you need to make sure you're on the correct stroke. To verify the stroke, make sure the intake mark on the intake cam sprocket is at about the 2 o'clock position, and the exhaust mark on the exhaust cam sprocket is at about the 10 o'clock position. If the cams are in these positions, you're ready for disassembly. If the cam marks are opposite, just rotate the crankshaft one full revolution and check again. If the timing system is failed, take care in rotating individual shafts due to possible piston to valve contact. This is an interference engine. Let's start with the disassembly. Using a 32 millimeter or 1¼ inch wrench or socket, remove the primary tensioner. Remove the upper guide. Next, remove the exhaust cam sprocket using a 24 millimeter or 15/16 wrench on the camshaft's hex feature to hold the camshaft. Discard the cam sprocket's torque to yield bolt. Remove the tensioner guide through the cam drive chest. Next, using a 10 millimeter hex drive, remove left-hand guide bolt access plug, then remove the left-hand guide. Remove the intake cam sprocket and discard the torque to yield cam sprocket bolt. You can then remove the chain through the top of the engine. Remove the crank sprocket. Ensure the key stays in place. Now go ahead and remove the oil nozzle. Now we can start with the balance shaft components. Start with the balance shaft tensioner. Now remove the balance shaft tensioner guide, followed by the left-hand balance shaft chain guide, and then the upper guide. Now remove the balance shaft drive sprocket or inner crank sprocket, followed by the balance shaft chain. Using a 5/32 punch or drill bit in the hole on the balance shaft bearing carrier, engage a tooth of the balance shaft sprocket to hold the shaft and remove the bolt and sprocket. Repeat this process on the other side. Also note, this is the water pump. If you plan to replace the pump, now is the opportune time to do so. Before we get started on the installation, here are some things you need to know. Let's start with the chains. GM has had several variations of markings on the primary and balance shaft chains over the years. Here is Cloyes' current design chain with one yellow marked link and two black marked links. The same principle applies to all the different designs. There is one uniquely marked link, which always aligns to the mark on the respective intake shaft sprocket, and two similarly marked links that align to the marks on the exhaust sprocket and the crankshaft sprocket. See our current chain and instructions on our website. For those of you with a later model Ecotec engine equipped with variable valve timing, you're going to see a difference in the cam sprockets. VVT equipped engines use a phaser assembly as opposed to standard cam sprockets. Despite the difference in appearance and functionality, there is little difference in installation. The marks on the phaser assemblies still align to the color timing marks of the chain in the same locations, and like the earlier sprockets, the phasers will only index onto the camshafts one way. The phaser attachment bolts are torque to yield, just like the non-VVT sprocket bolts. However, they do have a different torque specification. Tighten VVT phaser attachment bolts to 22 foot-pounds plus an additional 100 degrees. GM does offer a cam phaser holding tool for the torquing process. However, the process we show in this video without the tool is acceptable. If your engine is turbocharged or supercharged, pay attention to this. GM used a different inner crank sprocket to drive the balance shaft chain on forced induction engines. The inner crank sprocket included in the 9-4202S balance shaft chain kit will not work due to an overall thickness difference between the two designs. The original sprocket must be reused or a replacement must be sourced. Cloyes does not offer this sprocket. All Cloyes aftermarket balance shaft sprockets are an improved design that eliminate the OE cushion rings. The sprockets are a direct and improved replacement to the originals. The sprockets are marked intake and exhaust, so ensure to install the sprockets on the correct shafts. Both chain tensioners used in the Ecotec engines must be installed in their deactivated state and activated against the tensioner guide. The balance shaft chain tensioner uses a pin that is simply pulled after installation to activate the tensioner. Due to the ratcheting mechanism, the tensioner cannot be installed in the activated state. To deactivate a balance shaft chain tensioner that has been installed and activated, you must turn the piston 90 degrees, compress the piston, turn it back 90 degrees, then insert the pin. Do not use any gasket or silicone when installing this tensioner. The Ecotec primary tensioner has been through three design changes. The first was a two-piece design with an O-ring. Second was also a two-piece design, but the O-ring was removed. And third is a captive one-piece design. Cloyes supplies the latest version that supersedes all previous designs. The tensioner has an internal ratcheting mechanism that requires the tensioner to be disassembled in the event that an activated tensioner needs to be deactivated. A deactivated tensioner will allow the piston to be pulled in and out freely. This is the state the tensioner must be installed. An activated tensioner will have spring pressure behind the piston. To deactivate an activated tensioner, you must remove the snap ring and pull the inner assembly out of the housing. Then compress and turn the cage assembly clockwise until it stops. When released, the assembly should stay compressed. Now reinstall the assembly back into the housing and reinstall the snap ring. The activation process for this tensioner will be discussed later. We are now ready to start the installation. Start by installing the improved balance shaft sprockets. Remember to install the correct sprocket on each side. Utilize the same punch or drill bit used during disassembly and torque the bolts to 37 foot-pounds. Next, install the inner crank sprocket followed by the balance shaft chain. Note, the balance shaft system must be properly timed to prevent excessive engine vibrations. As I explained earlier, start with the uniquely colored link of the chain and align it to the mark on the intake balance shaft sprocket. The mark on the intake sprocket should point straight up to 12 o'clock and align with the colored link. Next, move over to the exhaust side and align the similarly colored link to the mark on the exhaust sprocket at about the 6 o'clock position. Wrap the chain around the water pump and align the other similarly colored link to the mark on the crank sprocket at about the 6 o'clock position. With the chain installed on all sprockets, go back and make sure all marks are still aligned properly. We can now install the balance shaft chain guides. When installing the guides, make sure the chain is installed between the raised edges of the guide's contact surfaces. Start with the upper guide, followed by the left-hand guide, then the tensioner guide. All balance shaft guide bolts torque to 89 inch-pounds. Install the balance shaft chain tensioner and torque the bolts to 89 inch-pounds. Ensure timing marks are all still aligned and pull the activation pin. Before installing the oil nozzle, make sure the passage is free from oil sludge and debris. Torque the bolt to 89 inch-pounds. Now install the crank sprocket. We can now install the timing chain. Wrap the chain around the intake cam sprocket with the uniquely colored chain link aligned with the intake cam sprocket timing mark. Feed the chain down through the cam drive chest, ensuring the chain goes around both sides of the engine block casting bosses, and work the bottom of the chain over the crankshaft nose. Then install the intake cam sprocket and hand tighten the new torque to yield cam sprocket bolt. Make sure the sprocket's indexing features index completely into the camshaft. Install the tensioner guide through the cam drive chest and torque the bolt to 89 inch-pounds. Install the exhaust cam sprocket with the exhaust timing mark and the similarly colored chain link aligned. Loosely install the cam sprocket bolt, leaving the sprocket key feature disengaged from the camshaft. Use a 24 millimeter wrench to turn the intake camshaft counterclockwise to allow the exhaust cam sprocket indexing feature to properly engage with the camshaft. While doing this, you must also make sure that the crankshaft sprocket mark aligns properly with the appropriate chain link timing mark. If the crankshaft timing mark does not align properly, you can slightly rotate the crankshaft by hand in the appropriate direction and try again. Once the exhaust cam sprocket is engaged and all marks are aligned, hand tighten the torque to yield bolt. Install the left-hand guide and torque the bolts to 89 inch-pounds. Next, install the left-hand guide upper bolt access plug using some thread sealant on the threads. The plug torques to 66 foot-pounds. Install the primary chain tensioner. The tensioner torques to 55 foot-pounds. Before activating the tensioner, shift all chain slack to the tensioner side using the harmonic balancer and note the amount of slack gathered above the crank sprocket. Verify once more that all timing marks are still aligned properly. Now, using a soft tip pry bar or similar tool, reach down through the cam drive chest and apply pressure to the chain at the top of the pivoting tensioner guide. For the tensioner to activate, you must compress the tensioner approximately 1/8 of an inch, then release. Once released, the internal spring of the tensioner will be operational and you should notice most of the chain slack taken out. With the tensioner activated, you are now ready to torque the torque to yield cam sprocket bolts. Use a 24 millimeter wrench on the camshaft's hex features as backup during the process and tighten the sprocket bolts to 63 foot-pounds plus an additional 30 degrees. Now install the upper guide. Torque the bolts to 89 inch-pounds. The engine is now in time. It is not advised to rotate the engine by hand beyond this point. If the engine happens to be rotated, the colored timing marks on the chain will not immediately come back around and realign to the marks on the sprockets. But the sprocket timing marks will come back to their original positions every two rotations of the crank. You can now install the front cover and the valve cover. The front cover bolts torque to 18 foot-pounds and the valve cover bolts torque to 89 inch-pounds. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, please call our tech line and please subscribe to our channel.